Hey everybody, we're talking about the really good news from God that you are pure. This is really good news and there is no bad news. We learn from the Apostle Paul that whenever we're tempted to worry, we can go to God. Tell God what we're concerned with and then trust Him. And as we do, He literally guards our heart and our mind. And the primary way that that happens is by what we think about. Paul writes in Philippians 4:8, he says, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is right, whatever is pure, dwell on these things. Meditate on these things. Think about these things. Instead of worrying, think about whatever's pure. So, what does pure mean? Well, in the original language that this was written in, it means to be thoroughly cleansed, consecrated, sanctified, clean, to be made absolutely pure. All right, who is pure? You are, really. Whether you know it or not, whether you feel like it, whether you believe it or not, you are pure. We all are. Everyone is. See, everyone died with Christ at the cross. Our old self died, and when we were raised with Christ, we were raised as a new creation. And that word meant of a new kind, unprecedented, novel, uncommon, unheard of, something that didn't exist before. And that new creation, which is you and me and everyone, is pure, right with God, set apart for God, one with God, in union with God, whether we choose to be or not. 1 Corinthians 1:30, Paul wrote this, God has already united you with Jesus Christ. For our benefit, God made Jesus to be wisdom itself. Christ made, past tense, us, all of us, right with God. He made us pure and holy, and He freed us from sin. Now, 2 days ago, I gave you all a way to get the most out of our time together, to practice several times saying, I have been made permanently right with God. Everyone else has been made permanently right with God. Well, we're going to do the same thing today. We're going to expand that and say, I have been made permanently right and pure with God, and everyone else has been made permanently right and pure with God. As we say that out loud, and often you can put it in your own words, and meditate on it, we're doing what Paul tells us to do in Philippians 4. Whatever's right, whatever's pure, think about, meditate, dwell on these things. And as we dwell on the truth that we and everyone else is already permanently right with God and that we're already pure, we'll start to believe that truth. We'll start to see ourselves the way we really are. And we'll start to see everyone else in Christ already being made pure and right with God. Folks, as you come to know these things, it literally changes your life in an amazing way. You'll no longer have doubts about yourself and God. You won't worry about your future destination. You won't wonder whether or not you're good enough. You won't wonder if you've committed the unforgivable sin. You won't worry about your mom or your grandmother or your child or your spouse or your friend. The peace of God that passes all human understanding will literally guard your hearts and minds and remind you whenever you start to worry that these things are true. One more time, let's say it together. I have been made permanently right and pure with God, and everyone else has been made permanently right and pure with God. Thanks, everybody. Paul Gray saying, see you next time.